Welcome to Courageous Leadership with Virginia Prodan, training you to lead with courage.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to our Courageous Leadership. We are so happy to have you here. We always love to encourage people that under any circumstances, they can discover the courageous leader in them, that they have that because God already put the skills in them so they can make a difference. They can make a contribution wherever God placed them, and they can make an impact, a specific impact that God wants for them to do it and live a successful and a significant life.
Yes.
We also want to invite people that exemplify that courageous leadership. And today we have a very, very special guest, Judy Pogler. She is a courageous leader. She is a person who impacts not only with her business, but also with her ministry, with her books, with her international speaking events, people all over the world. So welcome, Judy, here. Thank you so much for taking the time to be here. And I will let you introduce yourself to the audience.
Hello, I'm Judy Pogue. And Virginia, you already know that we love you so much. We first met you at the Museum of the Bible with Jackie Green. And it was such a blessing when we heard your testimony, because we knew you were a warrior for the Lord. Even though you're a little package, you are dynamite. And when you speak, the world listens. So we are so honored to have your beautiful testimony and being able to share this special time with you today. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. I would love for you to tell the audience, every age, young, middle, older, mm-hmm. how you started, because okay. many of them are saying, oh, maybe I don't have, maybe, and maybe many of them will be surprised. Mm-hmm. You know? So we would love to hear that. Yes.
Well, I think that I've always had a call in my life since 7 years old, really, really young. And then I felt a real call at 13 to be either a pastor's wife or a missionary or something like that. But I married my husband many years ago. We started a construction company, and he felt a call to missions as well as I did. And we started doing some projects, just giving. The first thing he said, the first week we were married, 10% goes back to Jesus. And we tithed and we gave. And then we started little by little getting involved in missions and missions, because we loved to impact our society and we loved to change the world. So over 40 years ago, we got involved in Chiapas, Mexico, in different parts of Mexico, and we started building churches. We have two clinics or an orphanage. We actually, Virginia, you don't know this, but we just got back 2 weeks ago. And it was just incredible to get to see them after the COVID had shut everything down. And just to see how they are. The churches are still going. The orphanage is great. They have 120 children, and things are just exploding. And so I've always felt like I had a call on my life. And then, as you know, several years ago, I wrote the book, Awaken Sleeping Beauty. And that was impacted by all the things I had done the years before. You know, and I love what you said about people don't understand what age they're at. You know, is it too late? Is it too early? And I say, you just listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit. You just follow the desires of your heart and be faithful. And then God opens doors. I mean, just your story is so incredible to me, how God opened international doors. So I would say to the people out there, don't be discouraged. Just be faithful, right? And when you're faithful, God opens the doors. And I just want everybody to be understand it's not too late. It's still time. God has something for you to do that no one else can do. That's very important.
It is so, so amazing what you said, and true in the same time. And no matter, I know that people have questions if they just start walking with the Lord, but even if they have been walking with the Lord for a very long time. Mm-hmm. And I will give a personal example, because a lot of people think that if you walk with the Lord, and you will always know, you will never have doubts and everything, which is not true. We are humans, and we're always going to have doubts, but we have to bring the doubts, like you said, to the Lord and seek his guidance. It's so interesting, because a few years ago, maybe 2 years ago, I was praying, and the Lord put on my heart to build a church in the town where I grew up. Mm-hmm. You remember that I was the child of a family. Mm-hmm. And when the Lord put that on my heart, I just jumped and I said, Lord, first of all, I don't have the money. Second, it will be so painful for me to go back to that town and relieve everything. And very gently, the Lord said, it will be full healing for you. And it will be an amazing opportunity for people to be healed in that town and see my power. I shared with a friend of mine, and I said, I don't have the money. And they look at me and I said, why do you care about that? When God gives you something, he will provide the resources. So like you, I am saying to them, don't feel guilty that you doubt. We are humans, and we doubt because we think that we have to have everything under control. No, God will have it. And also, seek God guidance. And I love what you said, that it's so true. We all have specific skills, specific talents that God gave us, and he wants to use them for his glory. So look at what God gave you and use that.
Yes. Okay. And so what I think happened, because I was just following the Lord, one day the Lord spoke to me, and you probably know about my book, Judy. It's Awake and Sleeping Beauty. The Lord spoke to me and said, Judy, I'm going to use your voice to wake up the sleeping beauties. I didn't understand that. I studied every sleeping beauty. I stayed up for hours and hours, and I went to the original sleeping beauty written in the 1400s. And I said, God, and you know this, how the Lord will just speak something to you and you follow his lead. And he said, look through everything. And then I saw Sleeping Beauty. It said, when she fell asleep, her mother, her father, the butler, the baker, the whole kingdom fell asleep, the whole castle fell asleep. And the Lord said to me that women are a key to waking up this world. We know how to love. We know how to listen. We hear things that men will never hear just because God built us that way. So I wrote this book, never knowing I would go and finish the book in a castle in Ireland. And the Lord took me to Ireland and Scotland. And then after that, I was able to go to 10 different countries doing business conferences and women's conferences. But what I want to say to your listeners is that sometimes they say, Lord, I'm finished. I'm too old. I'm not educated enough, or I don't have enough finances. And just like you, when God puts it in your heart, God opens those doors that no man can shut, as you well know. So it's an incredible thing. It's such an adventure to follow the Lord. And you have the stories to prove it too.
Yes, that is so true. What you said brought to me another question that I want to ask, because it's so dear to me. I know that the culture is against mothers staying home, molding their children for God and to change generations to come. What would you say to them to be encouraged, because they have such an important role, but they don't hear things like from me and from you every single day, and you will encourage them so much?
Well, I do. I get that question very often. And what I say to them is there are seasons of your life. Now, some women have to work and some people want to work. That's fine. My calling when my sons were small, I have three sons. I now have 10 grandchildren. But my calling was really to raise them and to help when I could in our commercial construction company, Poe Construction. So I did that. But that was the time, Virginia, for me to learn, for me to study, for me to hear the voice of the Lord, to pray. And I can tell you, you may not see the harvest when the kids are little, but you will see it. I say you pay now or pay later. It was so important that I raise godly sons and godly children that I was willing to sacrifice. And I can tell you, at one time, I remember seeing all these people doing all these beautiful things. And I was just crying, saying, Lord, did you forget about me? Because I know that you have called me. And I heard the Lord say, you be faithful. And I'll never forget this. He said, if you be faithful to do what I've called you to do, I will bless you so much. I will open up doors that you will not even believe. If you will do the first things first, which was care for my family, my husband, be faithful to the Lord in a Bible study. And when you do that, then God opens the windows of heaven, just exactly like you've seen. It's miracles. It's miraculous to see what God does when you are faithful.
Mm-hmm. It is so important what you said. And I want to outline, I am grateful because the Holy Spirit pointed you to say, if you need to work, work, if you can stay, because as a single mom,
yes,
I had to work. Right. I had to work. But God helped me to work. I don't know how I did it. I work. I took three kids in the morning to three schools. I brought them home. I worked when I was in law school as an assistant to my professors. And they were so kind to me that they would allow me to take the work at home. Mm-hmm. So when my kids were home, I was able to work from home. Mm-hmm. And at that time, I was just so overwhelmed, but I didn't realize that I presented in front of them that I was faithful, that working hard, you can do great things. And by the grace of God, I raised three kids who went to very good schools like SMU, Harvard Law School, United States Air Force, and they graduated and they served the Lord. And they do, you know, the same things because, like you said, one other thing that I want to outline is this. Your kids will do what they will see you doing, not what they will see you hear you saying. Mm-hmm. So your actions are very, very important. Very important.
Well, I think what God does is he gives you a special grace. If you have to work, God puts a special grace on your children. And I think that we just need to listen. What is our season? There are different seasons of our life, different callings. And what, you know, just hearing your story and reading your story, God's favor was on your life. So incredible that he gave you the grace and the energy and the finances and the time to work, but also raise your children. Now, I would say, that's a special anointed grace from the Father because not everybody has that. But I believe that when you listen to the Holy Spirit and you follow the call, he meets you where you're at. If you're a single mother, and I know there are many, many single mothers out there, and God bless you. And you know what? God's going to meet your needs. Don't be discouraged. And I want us just to encourage them today because we know hundreds now, and they are, you know, God is really their husband and their father, and he will meet their needs. So I'm glad that you said that because we need to speak to all the audiences because there's all different ages, all different situations. But when you grasp hold of the Lord's plan, he will guide you. He will provide, just like you said.
Exactly, because the Bible said even at the older age, I will take care of you.
Yes.
God did not say, I will let you take care of yourself, right, or your kids will take care, or the government, or
that's
somebody
right
else. God's promise is there. And if you're faithful, like you said, you mm-hmm will see all this mm-hmm coming to fruition. And I also want to emphasize how beautiful you said that we have a calling for a different a stage in our life. Mm-hmm. That was my calling, you know, when my kids are home. By the grace of God, I can travel and I can speak mm-hmm all over the world now because I am by myself. Mm-hmm. And if I stop in one place or another where my kids might be, I can visit them or I can mm-hmm make a special visit to them mm-hmm and so forth. So God will provide for you wherever you are. Mm-hmm. Now, I want my audience to be able to get in touch with you. So I would love for you to tell them, you know, if they need anything, mm-hmm, what your business mm-hmm does, what your ministry does, where they can find your book, because okay you have a wealth of influence.
Well, thank you so much. Well, the place to get my book is judypogue.com. We have two nonprofits. One's MinutemanDisaster.org, and the other one is PogueFamilyMissions.org. The Pogue Family Missions funds the things that we do in different nations, particularly in Chiapas. Pogue.com is where they can get, JudyPogue.com is where they can get a hold of me for the book or also for speaking engagements. I'm so happy that things are starting to open up. And I know you've seen that because we are usually this time of year in Brazil, Peru, we've been Germany, Nicaragua. And I mean, last year, the whole world closed down. And so we're just now starting getting other speaking engagements because what we do is we do Esther conferences, business conferences, we do women's conferences, but we also work with businessmen and women because what we have found, as you well know, we reach more people in the marketplace. Like we love to go talk to people about their business. We need to, you know, we give them information or advice. And if we don't know, we get some help because Christian business men and women need to be encouraged. They need to understand that when they have a business, it's like a church. It really is. They preach the gospel every day. Like in our Pogue construction company, every Monday morning, they have prayer. We have counselors. We have pastors that go pray with people. We have financial people that help. So we actually make this a safe haven for our employees. And so I go around the country with my helper, or she speaks with me, Dana Vestal. And as you know her too,
yeah,
she is a great speaker and has been a pastor's wife for 10 years. And now she speaks, but we go and we help these other churches. We help businesses. And, you know, I'm ready for it to open up. We miss our friends in Brazil and Peru and Mexico. And so I'm praying that this next year, Virginia, I know you feel the same way, that God just opens the doors up again, because I believe we're headed for the greatest revival we have ever seen. People are hungry. People are desperate. They want hope. And you and I, we have the answers because we have the word of God, which is life. And I believe the biggest thing that we need, and I see this in you, and I want to tell you how much I love you for that. You have passion.
Yeah.
And a lot of people have lost their passion. They've lost their drive. And every time I'm watching you, you're somewhere, you're all over the world and you're speaking and you're declaring the gospel of Jesus. And God is opening up doors. And I love so much that you have that passion and that zeal. And I think that it's contagious. So I'm glad you're just preaching this gospel and giving the story of life, because we are life givers. We have the power to encourage and give hope. And I'm just so thankful that you let me speak today. And I'm honored that I even know you. Your story is incredible. And I have no idea where you're going from here. I'm excited about it.
I am excited too. And I have to tell you, we have to organize something that we can take you and your group to Romania and we can do more things together. But you have a wealth of information. You have a passion too. That's maybe why we are so connected to each other, because it's the passion for the Lord. Mm-hmm. I just want to thank you so much for coming. We have so much to discuss. We're going to invite you again. And I just want to thank you so much for being here.
Well, I'm very honored. It's just a joy to see what you're doing and to partner with you. And we're going to believe that this next year is the best year we've ever had.
Amen. Amen to that. I agree.
If you want to know more about Virginia Prodan, her coaching program, buy her book, Saving My Assassin, or invite Virginia to speak at your events, visit virginiaprodanbooks.com.